Hey guys, welcome back. And in the last video we completed the model of this mortar, and today we are going to model the rest of it. So let's start with creating this cart. Let's go to front view and take a cylinder, rotate it like this, but enable discrete rotation and place it like this. Bring it out and let's match it with this cylinder. Decrease the radius. To 0.43, and also subdivisions to, let's take 14, now let's take a plane, bring it out, again go to front view and rotate this. Remove all these subdivisions, keep it one by one and increase the width. Like this. And place it like this. Now select this plane and this cylinder and go to mesh, then in the boolean select this difference and change the classification to normal. Now select this plane again and go to edit, delete by type history, change the pivot to center. Now you'll see all these vertices. We need to connect these, so take the multicut and start connecting these one by one. So we are done with this. Again go to edge mode and select this edge and drag it down with pressing shift to extrude. And again select these two, press R and press shift, then scale it to extrude. One more time, select all these three edges and extrude them like this. Now select these two, again scale and press shift. Go to vertex mode and select these vertices, pull them down a little bit, and these ones. Now it looks good. Now select this plane and press Ctrl E to extrude. Add some thickness. Let's take 0.6 or maybe 0.5. Now go to edge mode and select these edges. And bevel. Keep the fraction to 0.5 and increase one segment. or maybe decrease the fraction to 0.35 should be fine. Now you see all these vertices. Do one thing, just go to edge mode and select this edge, press Control, right click and go to edging utilities and then split. Now go to top view and face mode, select half of it and delete. Now go to front view and in the vertex mode, select all these vertices and select this merge vertices to center. Now again go to merge vertices and target weld tool, select this vertex and weld it here. Do the same for these vertices like this. You can weld one by one or you can just select all of them and then merge. Now again in the vertex mode, take this multicut and start connecting these vertices. I left these two vertices because leaving it would make this a chord polygon. Again multi-cut and connect these. So we have left these vertices. Let's connect these two. Go to front view and take a multicut tool, press Control and add one edge here and one on the side here, add one on the top and on this side. Now connect this vertex to this one and this one to this edge on the top. Go to vertex mode, select all of them, press R and scale them to make it straight. Do the same for this edge like this. Now go to edge mode and select these two extra edges and delete. Now go to vertex mode and select all these vertices, then use merge vertices to center and weld it to this one. Do the same for these vertex and select them, then merge them to center and then weld to this one. Now we have some space to connect these vertex. Again take multi-cut and select them, then connect. Same for this side. So now these are all connected now. Now go to top view and change this pivot first. Press D and V to snap it to this edge and create a duplicate. Now go to your channel box and in the scale Z add -1, select both of them and combine. Go to vertex mode and select these vertex in the middle. Go to merge vertex and merge vertices. Make sure these are merged. Go to edge mode, select this edge and delete it. To make these corners a little soft, just go to edge mode and select all these edges. And go to mesh display and select this soften edge. Place it like this. Now go to top view and change the pivot again. Go to wireframe mode and press D then X to snap it to the grid and place it in the center of this grid. Create another duplicate and go to scale Z then again -1. Now we need to rotate this. Now select this mortar. Combine it and go to front view. Rotate it like this. Maybe a little bit more. Like this. Now go to front view again and select this. Delete the other one. Select this mortar and place it on this block. Go to vertex mode and select these vertices and pull them down like this. Again, go to top view and select this. Create a duplicate. Again, open the channel box and in the scale Z add -1. Now we have set up our mortar. Let's create the base for this. Pick a cube, pull it down and go to right view. Place it like this. And scale it. Go to wireframe mode and again rotate this. and pull it up like this. Go to front view and select this cannon and align it like this. Then select both these blocks, go to vertex mode and select these vertex on the back and extend them just a little bit. And also this base. Now we have to create the wood planks for this base. So go to edge mode, select this edge and go to connect tool and add 4 connections. Now go to face mode and right view, select all these 4 divisions and delete them, and also this face. Select this edge and use fill hole. Now go to edge mode and select all these edges, then bevel, decrease the fraction and increase one segment. Now go to right view and create some duplicates. Place this one here like this and press shift D to create duplicates with transformation. So we have created the base. Let's add some support in the front and the back. So again, take a cube, bring it out in the front and go to right view, place it like this and scale it. Go to vertex mode and select these vertex and pull them up till here, and also these vertex like this. Now go to edge mode and select all these edges and again bevel. Decrease the fraction to 0.25 with one segment. Now we need to add a support for the back. So take another cube and place it on the back. Go to top view and scale it. Like this. Go to back view and place it on the base. Vertex mode and extend these vertex, pull them up like this. And also go to object mode and then pivot mode. Place it down here. And rotate this like this and put it here. Now again go to vertex mode and select these vertex, pull them down to align with the base, and also these ones. And again go to edge mode, select all the edges and bevel, increase one segment and decrease the fraction to 0.2. And I think that's enough for today. And in the next video, we're going to add some more objects and details. So that's it for today. And if you like this video, then subscribe to the channel. And I'll see you in the next video. Till then, thank you for watching.